Diagnostic hysteroscopy is a commonly performed gynecologic procedure to evaluate the endometrial cavity. Hysteroscopy is a term derived from the Greek words hystera, which means uterus, and scopio, which means to view. The indications of diagnostic hysteroscopy are abnormal uterine bleeding, infertility, suspected intrauterine mass, suspected intrauterine adhesion, missed IUD, recurrent pregnancy loss, postcoital bleeding, menorrhagia, hyperplasia or polyp, secondary amenorrhea, alteration on ultrasonography, alterations on hysterosonography, postoperative control, cervical polyp, postmenopausal bleeding, diagnosis and classification of submucous fibroid, diagnosis and staging of endometrial carcinoma. The contraindications are pelvic infection, pregnancy, cervical carcinoma, and heavy uterine bleeding. Most of the classic contraindications of diagnostic hysteroscopy, such as the presence of an active pelvic infection or cervical cancer, are not considered anymore as absolute, but rather as relative. In these cases, the examination can be performed, but the surgeon must observe adequate precautions. The potential spread of an infection caused by intrauterine manipulation and the pressure of the distending medium may increase the risk of spreading infection, so prophylactic antibiotics should be given. Hysteroscopy can be performed without any major risk of spreading malignant cell in patient with invasive cervical carcinoma. However, hysteroscopy in presence of invasive cervical cancer has no practical value if we exclude the differential diagnosis of a primitive adenocarcinoma of the endocervix, a very rare form of cancer. Special care is required in discussing hysteroscopy in early pregnancy. This can be performed without affecting the pregnancy, although the indications are few. They include the removal of a lost IUCD to avoid the risk of septic abortion. Preoperative preparations. Usually, we use oral analgesic 30 minutes before the procedure. For cervical dilatation, in cases of tightly closed cervix, misoprostol may be given orally or parvaginally. Sometimes, local anesthetics injection given into the cervix before the procedure. Best time to perform the diagnostic hysteroscopy is after menstruation. Anesthesia. Local anesthesia and general anesthesia both are used in cases of diagnostic hysteroscopy. You should be able to go home shortly after the procedure in cases of local anesthesia, and it also called office hysteroscopy. If you had general anesthesia, you may need to wait until its effect have worn off. The complications are cramping, abdominal pain, bleeding, uterine or cervical perforation, and sometimes fluid overload. The advantages of diagnostic hysteroscopy are: it can be done as a OPD procedure, in immediate diagnosis performed by this procedure. Sometimes minor surgical procedure can be done followed by diagnostic hysteroscopy, like biopsy taking, IUD removal, polyp removal, and mild adhesiolysis. An accurate diagnostic technique is that it allows direct visual observation and accurate localization of pathology. This is a low-risk technique that uses the endometrial canal, the natural passageway of the body, to gain entry into the intrauterine environment. Now we demonstrate how to perform the diagnostic hysteroscopy. Saline is used to distend the cavity. This is cervix. External os, and now we pass through the internal os. This is the endometrial cavity. This is the right tubal ostium. This is the left tubal ostium. This is the normal endometrial cavity. And we withdraw the hysteroscope from the endometrial cavity through the cervix. Thank you for watching this video.